San Francisco, extracting the signal from the noise. It's theCUBE, covering VMworld 2015. Brought to you by VMware and its ecosystem sponsors. And now your host, John Furrier.
Okay, welcome back everyone. We are live here in Moscone North Lobby for VMworld 2015. This is theCUBE, SiliconANGLE's flagship program. We go out to the events and extract the signals from the noise. With new director set, innovation here, two sets going on. The main CUBE over there, Dave Vellante interviewing Primary Data, and I have the VC of Primary Data by coincidence, Ping Li, General Partner at XL Partners, General Partner at XL Partners. Welcome back to theCUBE.
Yeah, good to be back, John.
So you're one of the top dogs at XL. You guys are doing extremely well, great investments.
Thank you.
The world is changing, you're in the enterprise, one of the top VCs in the enterprise. You're doing a lot of deals. One of them, Primary Data, as I mentioned, is on theCUBE live right now on the other channel. What are you seeing? What are you guys looking at right now? I saw you at LinuxCon scouring there. Obviously DevOps,
yep.
Software, Linux.
Yeah.
This is open source. Share what you're working on.
You know, I think this is one of those periods of time and innovation where there's not just one trend that's going on, it's the confluence of like five different trends. And it's creating a tremendous amount of opportunity from a startup and investing perspective, right? I think what you're seeing on the mobile proliferation, the cloud, a lot of the stuff around security, all these things are starting to come together. So we are investing along all those trends. We have companies that are trying to change how people and IT organizations think about how to secure their infrastructure from the endpoint, back to the data center, to the applications, to the data itself. We have companies in the container ecosystem that are trying to rebuild the compute stack around the new set of container technologies. So, you know, I think it's not a it's a period of time we call the Cambrian period where all different types of technology are emerging.
So, you know, I've heard you say words like, that's not a big enough idea to me and others, right. But that's really what's going on right now. There are big ideas that are viable.
Yeah.
That seems to be the theme here at VMworld. You heard Pat Gelsinger right. Laying out essentially probably one of the best presentations I've seen him do, really laying out some leadership around the future. So the period of incrementalism is kind of over, especially like in storage, for instance. You know, the cartel of EMC and NetApp and, you know, Pure's out there doing great. A new breed of startups are emerging in the enterprise. Could you share your opinion on what that looks like? The big ideas and the things that you look at specifically on the kind of entrepreneurs you want to bet on.
Yeah, I think Pat made a statement that 50 of the top 100 tech companies are going to turn over in the next decade. And I think that is probably an understatement. If I look at what's happening across the startup ecosystem, they are taking on the incumbents in ways that incumbents can't react to because there's so many of these trends that are happening for the first time in such a fast pace, right? I take a look at storage. 5 years ago, flash was kind of a consumer technology. Yeah. No one thought it was ready for the enterprise. Fast forward 5 years, companies like Nimble, Pure, Nutanix have taken that technology and re-changed the entire landscape and ecosystem for storage. And that one piece of technology is now being deployed in the cloud and lots of other places on the server with Fusion.io. And that's creating the opportunity for companies like Primary Data, which are building the software on top of those components to leverage storage virtualization, right? So I think you're getting these layering effect where each layer is creating an opportunity for another layer to abstract and to build bigger companies around it.
All right, some quick fun facts. What's the size of the fund you currently are investing in and deal flow sizes you guys are deploying on Series A's? What kind of numbers can you share?
So we're $1.5 billion venture and growth equity fund. You know, our venture fund still continues to do Series A behind great entrepreneurs trying to solve big problems and, you know, the
round size is 5 to 10?
Yeah, still the 5 to 10 Series A and go after, you know, when we say it's not about the money you put in, it's you know, what you do with the money, right? And, you know, with the cloud and open source technologies, it's pretty cost efficient to build and get the initial prototypes and get the products to market these days.
All right, so share with the folks out there the Ping Li investment thesis. As you look at the landscape in the enterprise and the VMworld ecosystem, what's your thesis? Do you have an algorithm? I mean, I don't say patterns, because pattern matching is not what the best VCs do. They tend to look at patterns in context to trying to connect the dots. So what do you look at? What's your thesis for connecting the dots to see around the corner for the next big opportunity?
Well, I think it starts with the entrepreneur. They're the ones that have to see around the corner. You know, our job is to find the entrepreneurs that know how to see around the corner and answer all the things you just said. But you know, I think it is the entrepreneurs that not only see the trend, but they can see where the trend will be in 3 years' time. Because the reality is, you know, once you start a company, it takes years to build. Even the great ones, right? So you can't necessarily solve a problem that's here today. You have to see what the problem is going to be down the road and how that problem becomes bigger over time.
And what about market areas that you're investing in? Obviously, you have the algorithm for understanding which entrepreneur, obviously, right. You're going to have to vet the entrepreneurs. You see thousands of pitches a year. What sectors are you looking at? Obviously, cloud, DevOps, you're at the Linux conference, I saw you there. What are you poking at? What are you networking into for meeting entrepreneurs?
I think we've done, we have a broad portfolio of security companies from CrowdStrike to Tenable to Lookout, but I think we're just scratching the surface in security. I think we are, IT organizations, consumers, enterprises are under attack from so many different angles that I think the attack vectors are so broad that there's going to be more and more security companies that we're going to look to invest in. I think what we're seeing around the container ecosystem continues to be very interesting. I think it's very early, but it shows a lot of promise in terms of the value it delivers. I look at our portfolio companies, who are a lot of startups that embrace leading technologies. They were the first to adopt AWS back in the day. They're the ones that are working on the container technologies and using the stuff that a lot of the Googles of the world.
There's still some blocking and tackling, kind of boring areas that are still huge money-making opportunities
where
there could be some efficiencies. Is there anything you could share there, sectors you like in terms of optimization? I don't want to say consolidation, but more, you know, those areas where there's just a lot of spend going on, whether it's WAN or backup recovery, primary data is kind of one of those crossovers between kind of a boring storage where they got a futuristic data play.
Yeah, no, I think primary data, another company we invested in called Cohesity in the backup space, they're all trying to generate efficiencies in this new cloud world. People are expecting much more agility in their infrastructure. They're expecting to be able to scale out and leverage commodity components, but they want all the manageability they had before, right? So they want all the things that they had in the past, but all the new things as well. And I think that creates a great opportunity for startups to intersect.
I know you're a humble guy, you don't like to toot your own horn, but what are your hottest deals that you're proud of, that you've done, that have exited, and what are the hot deals you have now? I know it's like asking a parent to say what's their favorite child, but what are the hot deals that have exited for you and the deals that are right now your favorites?
Well, I think examples of companies in our portfolio I think are disrupting industries. I think Cloudera, what they're doing around big data and taking not just Hadoop but other technologies to change how enterprises could derive value out of massive amounts of data that they have. I think companies like Slack is changing how enterprises are going to be communicating and employees to do messaging and collaboration. I think company like a Lookout, which is basically saying, hey, iOS and Android, they need their own set of security stack on top of them to make them usable in the enterprise, in fact, for consumers as well, right? So,
did you do the Slack deal?
My partner Andrew Bracha did the Series A.
Okay.
Yeah, so we've been in that for many
nice
years.
One.
Yeah, and that thing's explosive, right? I think it's because it's solving a problem, right? That a lot of people.
That's
have.
A new user experience.
Yeah, it's
software
in some ways
driven.
It's new. In some ways it's new. In some ways it borrows from a lot of the behaviors we develop on the consumer side, and allowing the enterprise users who are consumers at the end of the day to have that same level of ease of use, capabilities, and collaboration.
All right, final question for you, Ping. Share with the audience who's watching something that's unique in the market right now that you think that they might not be seeing or might not be obvious that you can see as something that's a disruptive signal around this new way, this shift that's happened, this Cambrian period, I would agree, is pretty amazing. It was a perfect storm of innovation happening right now. What areas would you say, hey, you know, you might not know it, but this trend is really kicking it off?
A trend that we're excited by is this, what we've been calling the APX world. If you look at companies like Uber, they're really just built on a couple APIs, right? A Maps API, Twilio, Payments API, and they obviously did amazing technology to stitch it all together. But I think that's going to become the trend. There's going to be more and more companies that are going to be able to abstract their technology into an API that allows others to build on top of. And that new layer, the APX layer, I think is going to be an area of
API-ification.
Yeah, we have a company called Segment.io, right? Which is an explosive company that's doing that around data. Allows you to connect up a lot of data sources in a very seamless way.
And the cloud obviously is powering all this, DevOps.
I think the cloud has been no longer are you focused on the infrastructure, the compute storage networking, but you're building this kind of abstraction layer that
we were talking on theCUBE yesterday that, we always debate with Weepon research team, you know, who's winning Amazon, and we're like, okay, Amazon won game one of a doubleheader.
Yeah.
So that's over, we all win public cloud. Right. Game two's a different game, the enterprise. Right. The rules are different.
Yeah.
No one's winning that yet. Amazon's clearly not winning the enterprise.
Well, I think Amazon is making a lot of traction in the enterprise, but I think you see Azure, you see Google Computing.
But the game's not even in the early innings, still in the enterprise.
It's very early. I think these, as explosive as these trends are, they also take time, right? The Cambrian period wasn't created overnight either, right? So,
so
I think all these things will take time to develop.
A decade is the Cambrian, period of time.
Exactly.
Amazon won game one. Ping, thanks for taking the time to come on theCUBE, our new director set here in Moscone at VMworld. Great to see you pound the pavements in Seattle. I mean, that's what it's all about in the VC world. Hustle,
yeah.
Right?
It's finding the next great deal.
Ping Li, XL Partners here on Side theCUBE. We'll be back with more after this short break.
Thanks, John.